Team Blaze, Colonel Samantha Weeks here along with my chief advice to give you an update on COVID-19. Thank you very much first for your continued patience and flexibility as we navigate this together as a community. We are working along with our state and county and city as well as the national level to make sure that we can take actions that protect our force first and foremost and protect our mission. So by now, I think most of you have seen the Secretary of Defense guidance regarding face coverings. Your leadership at the wing group and squadron level are talking to make sure that we can input that into our daily operations to care for you first and foremost.
Out of an abundance of caution, the Department of Defense has directed the wear of cloth face masks where practical for those who cannot maintain 6 feet of physical distance. This is in line with the guidance the CDC issued on Friday, 3 April. So what does this mean to you? Not every person at Columbus Air Force Base needs to wear a face covering. Who doesn't need to wear a covering? If you are able to maintain 6 feet of physical distance while performing your mission, you do not need to wear a face covering. If your duties require PPE not compatible with cloth face coverings, like our firefighters and our pilots in our T-6 and T-38 aircraft, you do not need to wear a face covering. If you are able to maintain 6 feet of physical distance in public areas, you do not need to wear a face covering. If you are inside your personal residence on the installation, you do not need to wear a face covering. So who does? If your duties prevent you from maintaining 6 feet distance from another individual, as in our defenders at the gate and some other specialties around the base, you do need to wear a face covering. If you are out in public areas within 6 feet of other folks, you do need to wear a face covering. And this includes our commissary, our BX, and if you are retrieving food from the to-go options here on base, you must wear a face covering.
So what do these face masks look like? We are currently working with our contracting squadron in the local community to acquire face coverings. Until then, you should visit cdc.gov and download their infographic that explains how to create a facial mask using household items such as cotton material and t-shirts. Your continued social distancing and limited movement are vital to our success.
So you've heard the information from the chief on the makeshift mask that we're gonna wear when we cannot do that physical distance of 6 feet. As the commander of this installation, I want to let you know that I'm not going to stipulate that it must be OCP, ABU, or any certain color. I'm going to ask each and every one of you to just put the mindset in when you are in uniform or you are at the workplace that you're putting a professional image forward. We don't have the luxury to ensure that we can have a certain color of material, so again, just asking you for a professional image. The last part I want to highlight with this is that we are not aware of new risks that are associated with the coronavirus, but we want to ensure that we take every practical measure to protect our service members and families and communities so that we can flatten this curve and fight the virus to the best of our ability. And lastly, I just want to thank each and every one of you for all that you're doing in your actions and your daily support of our mission and protecting our people, our families, and our community. I ask if you see somebody not within that 6 foot social distance, let us know. This is a new norm that we're trying to establish in everybody's daily lives. So help us to help each other to, you know, remind people of the physical distancing required. And please, if you have a concern, communicate it to us or your leadership team and let us know what you need to make sure that we can protect the force, to protect our mission, and work with the whole of government approach. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Team Blaze, this is Chief James down at the OSS and RAPCON to go visit with Staff Sergeant Dylan Fivecoat, 19th Air Force nominee to AATC for Airman of the Year. So we're going to go inside right now and meet with him and let him know the great news that he won.